Welcome to my channel. We have already discussed what is cash flow statement, the format of indirect method of preparing cash flow statement, how to determine net profit before tax and extraordinary items, and how to determine operating profit before working capital changes. Link for the previous videos given in the description box. Please check it. Today we are going to discuss how to determine cash flow from operating activities. This is the format of indirect method of preparing cash flow statement. Using this format, we are going to solve one problem. Problem: S Limited earned a profit of rupees 2 lakhs after charging or crediting the following items to its P&L account during the year 31/3/2017. Profit on sale of investment 4000, loss on sale of buildings 9000, depreciation on fixed assets 7000, amortization of goodwill 2000, provision for tax made 60000, income tax paid 50000, extraordinary income 10000. For additional details, opening information and closing information is given. All these details are related to current assets and current liabilities. Bills payable 5000 and 8000, creditors 12000, 16000, outstanding expenses 2000, bills receivable 20000, 18000, debtors 40000, 60000, prepaid expenses 2000, 3000, accrued incomes 5000, 8000, income received in advance 2000, 1000. Calculate net cash from operating activities for the year ending 31/3/2017. Now we will see how to determine cash flow from operating activities. Using the format, we are going to prepare cash flow statement. The first part of the cash flow statement is cash flow from operating activities. Cash flow from operating activities. The very first item under the heading operating activities is net profit before tax and extraordinary items. Look at the problem. The profit for the year is 2 lakh. We have to make some adjustments to the net profit to determine net profit before tax and extraordinary items. Here we have the format to determine net profit before tax and extraordinary items. With the net profit, we have to add certain items and we have to subtract certain items. Okay. So in this problem, we have provision for tax. Provision for tax we have to add with the net profit. Okay. Next, we are also having extraordinary income. Extraordinary income we have to deduct from the net profit. We have to determine net profit before tax and extraordinary items separately under the heading working notes. What is the profit? 2 lakhs. Net profit for the year 2 lakhs. With the net profit, we have to add provision for tax. Provision for tax. Amount is 60,000. 2 lakhs plus 60,000. 2 lakhs is 60,000. Extraordinary income we have to deduct from the net profit. Deduct extraordinary income. What is the amount? 10,000. After making adjustments, we will get net profit before tax and extraordinary items. After determining net profit before tax and extraordinary items, we have to write the amount in cash flow statement, net profit before tax and extraordinary item 2,50,000. Using the format we are preparing cash flow statement, the next step we have to adjust items of non-cash and non-operating items. Okay, now look at the problem and identify what are the non-cash items and non-operating items. First, profit on sale of investment. Any profit on sale of fixed asset and investment we have to subtract from the net profit. Profit on sale of investment we have to subtract. Loss on sale of buildings, any loss we have to add with the net profit. So we have to add loss on sale. Depreciation, it is a non-cash item, we have to add. Okay, next item, goodwill. Goodwill also we have to add. Now it is easy for us to make adjustments. First, add non-cash and non-operating items. We have to add loss on sale of buildings, depreciation and goodwill. Loss on sale of building. How much? It is 9,000. Okay. Next one, depreciation. Depreciation. Next, adjustment for goodwill. How much goodwill? 2,000. Next, we have to deduct items of non-cash and non-operating items. What are the adjustments? Profit on sale of investment. Profit on sale of investment. How much? 4,000. Okay. Total the non-cash and non-operating items, we will get 18,000. And here we have 4,000. 18,000 deduct 4,000, we will get 14,000. Okay. After making all the adjustments, now add 2,50,000 and 14,000. We will get operating profit before working capital changes 2,64,000. Okay. Operating profit before working capital changes. Look at the format. After determining operating profit before working capital changes, we have to adjust for current assets and current liabilities. Any decrease in current asset and increase in current liabilities, we have to add. And any increase in current assets and decrease in current liabilities, we have to subtract. Bills payable, current liability, increase in current liability. Increase in current liability, we have to add. Bills payable, 3,000 increase. Next information, creditors. Creditors, current liability. Current liability, increase in current liability, 4,000. Okay. Increase in current liability, we have to add. Creditors, how much increase? 4,000. Next one, outstanding expenses. Outstanding expenses, it is current liability. Decrease in current liability. Okay. Any decrease in current liability, we have to deduct. Outstanding expenses, how much? 1,000 rupees decrease. Okay. bills receivable, current asset, decrease in current asset. Decrease in current asset, add. Bills receivable, decrease 2000. Okay. Next, debtors. Debtors increase. Okay. It is current asset. Any increase in current asset, we have to subtract debtors. What is the amount? 20,000. Next one, prepaid expenses. Prepaid expenses, current assets, increase in current assets. Increase in current assets, prepaid expenses. Thousand. Next, accrued income. Accrued income is current asset. There is increase in current asset. Increase in current asset. Accrued income. How much? 3000 increase. Income received in advance. Current liability. Decrease in current liability. Decrease in current liability. Income received in advance. How much? 1000. Now find out the total. Here we will get 9000. Here 21000, 22000, 25000, 26000. 9000 minus 26000, the answer is in negative. We will get 17000. From the operating profit, we have to deduct 17000. We will get 2,47,000. Okay. This is cash generated from operations. Cash generated from operations. Look at this format. After determining cash generated from operations, we have to deduct income tax paid from cash generated from operations. Next, we have to adjust for extraordinary items. In this problem, we have income tax and extraordinary income. With the cash generated from operations, we have to deduct income tax. How much income tax? 50,000. 2,47,000 minus 50,000. We will get 1,97,000. Next, we have to add extraordinary income. Add extraordinary income. How much? 10,000. 1,97,000 plus 10,000, we will get 2,07,000 net cash from operating activities. 2,07,000. Thank you for the patient listening.